One of the key elements for growth and development of the body posture of a koi is food. And that really is no secret at all. Any Japanese koi breeder will share this openly with you. In this video, you will see how much food koi breeders in Japan are giving to their koi, and what food they are making use of in order to maximize growth and development. Next to that, I will share how you can calculate to give the exact right amount of food to your koi. We will do that with formulas based on body weight and water temperature. Anyway, before we start with the difficult stuff, let's first go to Japan and see how Japanese koi breeders feed their koi, how many times a day, and what food they are making use of. We are here at the Maruda Koi Farm, one of the Tategoi ponds. And Tategoi are the higher class koi where the breeder sees a lot of potential in. It are koi that are in the first year, not sold to customers as well, simply because the breeder sees a lot of value in them when growing them larger and then selling them. It mainly consists of Kohaku, Sanka and a few Showa as well. So some really serious koi. Still Tosai in the first year, now around 30 to 40 cm. And during summertime these koi will grow a lot. Average will be around 50 to 55 cm as Nissai end of this summer. And the largest ones will even be over 60 cm in length. This is one of the feeding rounds. Daily just over 2 kg of food is provided to around 120 tosai in this pound. Weekly around 50 kg of sake ikari. And this video is not sponsored at all, but I'm just mentioning what this koi farm is using, and especially on this pond as well. Marudo is making use of a floating and sinking mix, and he simply does that because he wants to prevent damaged and injured koi. When the koi splash and jump on floating food only, they are more likely to get damaged or injured in their fins. Using sinking food combined with floating spreads the koi a little bit more, also over the bottom of the pond. And for Marudo there are no other arguments why he is using sinking food as well. These higher tea koi are also fed with more color feed than most other varieties, and that goes up to percentages above 60% during the summer period. And this also includes a pellet feed based on shrimps to improve the color. While, well, especially in Europe we don't use a lot of color food, here in Japan it is really often used, and breeders mention that it is actually important to make use of color feed as well, including spirulina and astaxanthin. So we know that feeding is actually key for good growth. Observations are also really important. Maruda Koi Farm is watching together with their staff all their ponds very regularly, if possible every day. They observe their koi closely and monitor their body posture as well. And when koi do get too wide, they quickly start to reduce the amount of feed. So this pond is also heavily aerated using the spraying fountain in the middle of the pond. Really important in the summer period because the water temperatures do reach even up to 30 degrees or even higher than that, to prevent that koi actually take in less food because of lowering oxygen levels in the water. So it is really important. And this is the Shinoda Koi Farm together with Masanori Shinoda, the owner of the farm. The breeder is specialized in Hiwatsuri and Deutsche variety. In this pound we have around 152-year-old Hiwatsuri and Ginrin Showa, and almost 4 kg of food is going in on a daily basis when the summer temperatures are highest, so in July, August and September. Testing the feeding machine, and what you can see is also most of the food used is sinking. Masanori Shinoda is also doing that to prevent injuries and damage in the fins, dorsal fins, pectoral fins. And Shinoda is also doing daily checks at his mud ponds, monitoring his koi carefully. You can actually see that the Shinoda koi have a really good body posture, strong body postures on the Hiwatsuri, and he will make sure if he thinks that his koi are getting too wide in body, then he will slow the feeding machine a little bit down, less food on daily basis. And did you think that it was a lot of food already? Well, then think again, because this is again at the Manuda Koi Farm, their largest mud pound. Especially one colored koi are in here, Yamabuki Ogon, Chagoi, Karashi Goi, Mugashi Ogon. This feeding machine is really providing a lot of food. So as you can see, really a lot of food, all sinking, 3 kilograms in one run, and that 7 times a day, feeding 21 kilograms on a daily basis in one mud pound. And you will probably understand that this feeding machine will go on for a while. A lot of you ask me what food is being used in Japan. And actually that all depends on the quality and the varieties that are in the pound. I have visited and helped breeders for a longer period, also during the summertime. And often lower tier koi or one colored koi, just like in this pound, are fed with cheaper pellets, usually without a label or a brand. And these pellets are especially based on fish meal and rich of protein, most important for growth. While higher tier koi, as you've already seen in the beginning of the video, also at the Manuda Koi Farm, are often fed with sake ikari, which is more expensive of course, and for that reason the breeder only wants to use it on his best koi, so the best quality with the most potential, else the cost for lower tier koi will just be too high to even be able to sell them. In this pound are 210 nisai, so 2 year old koi, especially Mugashi Ogon, but also other one colored koi. Every week 70 kilo of pellet feed is provided via the feeding machine. So, and that is next to the natural food that is already available in the mud pound. So that means that Marudo in this pound is giving his koi 50 grams of food each on a daily basis. And these koi are not even that big, I think around 40 cm in size. Now we know something about feeding in Japan and what the breeders do. I will tell you something about how you can determine for your own koi pound how much food you have to give. And for that we have a few indicators that you can use to determine how much koi food you have to give to your koi. The two that I will discuss with you are body weight and water temperature. We can calculate the amount of food that can be given to our koi based on the total body weight. The higher water temperatures reach, the higher the percentage of food based on body weight we can give. But we first have to know the total weight of all our koi combined. And for that we have a few different approaches. The one I personally use to calculate body weight is a simple formula where we multiply the length of a koi with its body volume. So the formula looks like the following, and it actually is less difficult than it looks like. You probably know the length of your koi, or at least you can make a good estimation. But now, what is the value body volume exactly, and how can we make use of it? As it suggests, body volume is based on the body posture of a koi. Male koi are more slim than female koi, and for that reason their body factor is lower. But not to make it more complex, I suggest that we make use of an average body factor of 1.7, which is a fair value for the average koi, a pond with mixed female and male koi. If you really want to calculate it more precise, you can make use of a body factor of 1.6 for male koi and a body factor of 1.8 for female koi. Let's take an example of a koi that is 20 cm in size. The formula will look like the following. Using this calculation, we will see that the average koi with a size of 20 cm will weigh around 136 grams. This is quite a trustable indicator to calculate weight of a koi and base your feeding pattern on. But first you will have to calculate the total weight of all your koi. And to make that a little bit easier, I added this table for you so you won't have to calculate a lot. and for koi over 80 cm, I still would recommend to use the largest number in the stable. The reason for this is quite simple. Koi above 80 cm often are a little bit older and won't grow a lot in length. And since we base the amount of feed based on this formula, it is better to feed a little bit less. The next thing you will have to do is check your water temperature, because the higher the water temperature is, the higher the percentage of body weight and food that you can give to your koi. For temperatures above 24 degrees, you can give up to 2% of body weight. So if you have 10 kilograms of total koi, you can give 200 grams of food on a daily basis. But when water temperature is lower, you also have to reduce feeding. At a temperature of 18 degrees, I recommend that you only feed around 1.5% of body volume. So that would mean on the same 10 kilograms of koi that you can give only 150 grams daily. The table I'm showing you is my own schedule to determine the percentage of body weight I can use of. So at 10 degrees I only give around half a percentage of body weight in food. At 15 degrees I already give 1% and above 24 degrees I give 2% of body weight in food. But be aware that the more you start to feed, the higher the chance is that the conditions for your koi get worse. If you feed more, you get more waste in your water, higher ammonia levels and so on. So do monitor them carefully if you want to feed more. Hopefully this will help you in determining how much food you can give to your koi and maximize their growth. Hopefully you liked and enjoyed the video. Please comment below or like and consider to subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you in the next episode.